morning, Hollis Group. This is WHIA-TV bringing you the morning announcements.
Will you please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance and remain standing for the Hollis Creed?
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
As I pass through the doors of Hollis each day, I will strive to do my best in every way. I am committed to excellence and nothing less, because my education is the key to my success. I respect my school and those who teach and guide me. I respect myself and those who sit beside me. I will always do my share to show that I care. I am proud to be a Hollis student.
And 7th grade students, remember, applications for the Principal's Advisory Council are due tomorrow, Friday, October 19th, to Miss A. Williams. Also, 5th, 6th, and 7th grade students, do you want to make a difference? Do you want to serve your community? Do you want to be active in school? If you answered yes to all of these questions, apply to join the Student Government Association, or SGA, Executive Board. Applications can be picked up from Ms. Wisdom in room N301, and they are due tomorrow, Friday, October 19th. If you're interested in joining our math club as a mathlete this year, there is an interest meeting on Wednesday, October 24th at 2:45 p.m. in Ms. Ford's room, room N248 in the 6th grade pod. Please see Ms. Ford if you're interested so she can give you a permission slip to take home and be signed by your parent or guardian.
We are so humbled that so many of you have trusted us to keep you informed for decades, and our mission and commitment to you have remained the same, but we also always strive to lead the way with the latest technology.
Channel 2 anchor Fred Blankenship has a look at how much the technology of TV has changed since we first started in 1948.
We're standing here at the assignment desk at WSB-TV, the communications hub of our newsroom, and so much goes on here. We have scanners, we have computers, we have the phones, of course, and oh yeah, we have people who gather information every day to bring it into your home. Technology has come a long way in 70 years. Take a look.
WSB Television is on the air.
On September 29th, 1948, at 8 p.m., WSB hit the air for the first time.
We transmitted out of this tower in our backyard.
3 years later, WSB began transmitting from what was then the tallest tower in the world. Even in 1948, live shots were possible.
It took a long time to set up the shot, but you did have microwave back in those days.
In 1959, the first radar weather forecast aired. By the late 70s, it was in color.
You could tell the difference between light rain or heavy rain by the color. So that was quite a breakthrough to have colorized radar.
Color TV debuted nationally in the mid-50s. To produce something locally wasn't so simple. In 1965, WSB made the leap.
Oddly enough, they wanted to debut it on the Popeye Club.
Yeah, that's okay. Okay?
Yeah.
That same year, the Color Cruiser began lugging the 200-pound cameras used to broadcast Braves games live for years.
There's a new home run champion of all time!
For almost three decades, stories were shot on film, a slow and expensive process.
You go out and you shoot the film, and you somehow get it back to the station because the film had to be processed, and you had to wait for the film to come out. And, you know, always checking on your deadline.
In 1975, videotape arrived on the scene.
The speed was dramatic.
It took two machines to edit, one for record and one for playback.
And they were big and bulky. Stuff we use today, it's instant. As soon as you shoot it, you can see it, you can edit it.
In 1998, WSB was one of the first in the country to go digital. Tape was replaced with file storing cards.
One thing you need is your laptop. A laptop and a SD card.
WSB had the first live truck in the market. From there, satellite. And now two dozen live stream devices make going live possible from places never before imagined. We debuted a helicopter for the first time in 1978. Now, News Chopper 2 is joined by a fleet of 15 drones. Google and online scanners allow the assignment desk to deliver information to crews in the field quickly and accurately.
Bulletin, bulletin.
A little different from wires printing off each day.
From the time that we can get it to them, which is just seconds, they've got it and they've got it on air.
Ah, but they're also tweeting on Facebook, Snapchat, everything. Technology has sure changed. And of course, our WSB TV news app is a great way to get information. My, so much has changed in 70 years. Fred Blankenship, Channel 2 Action News.
The least, right? Mm-hmm. So much has changed and it's still changing. But what would we do without all that technology?
Well, I mean, TV changed the world.
It did. And continues to.
Yeah, and we'll be here for it.